السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
What's going on, Habibis? I'm Siraj Hashmi.
And I'm Jay Kobbe.
And we're the Habibi Bros. Welcome to another episode of Habibi Power Hour. Jay, happy 1 week since 9/11.
Thank you, Habibi. I thought you forgot.
I never forget. So, Habibis, make sure you hit that like, that follow, that join button, support the Habibi Bros. We're here live on Rumble, and only Rumble, because Rumble is the only place where Jay and I can take our shirts off, rub our nipples, and also claim that it's free speech. Of course, all of you will tune out, but you know, this is just the way it is, and it's also because we're family. So $5 a month, join our locals, where you can join the non-poor chat, our Habibi Discord server, and you get to watch me avenge our my Habibi in arms, Mujahid Kobbe, my co-host, my co-pilot, Jay, as he has fallen to the gremlin from Ohio, and I have avenged his death this week as Carl lost in what would appear to be a massacre of sorts.
It was absolutely a massacre. I mean, it was the hugest blowout. I mean, almost as big as I blow his mother's back out on Saturdays. That you blew this guy out. It was fantastic. It was really, really great. I'm on my redemption arc right now to get back into a really good standing in making sure I hit the playoffs. But we'll find out. I'm 0-2 right now. But next week, wow. Seems like next week is going to be a good one. I have some secret weapons I'm recruiting right now behind Carl's back.
Always behind Carl's back, as we know that everyone from the Carl lineage loves to have their back blown out.
That's how it is when you're from Ohio. I mean, you're a fucking you're a dirty whore. The way your parents raised you when you're from Ohio.
I love we're just picking out one of the Habibis. That's it.
And for $5 a month, Habibis, you can be the one we pick on too.
Get cyberbullied by the Habibis. Join our locals.
Get on the Discord server, especially if you're from Ohio. We're gonna be doing game nights. We're doing fantasy league. I mean, it's popping off like a FBI watch list for people in caves.
It's the hottest place to be that's not Jahannam, basically. Or for those of you who are not aware of what Jahannam means, it means hellfire in Arabic, just so you know, which we're probably all going to. But we're definitely living in it right now, aren't we, Jay?
Oh God, every single fucking day, especially, you know, I think honestly, UN assembly is one of the layers of hell. You know how Dante went through seven layers of the circles of hell?
Yeah,
the seven this circles. One is number 69.
Yeah. It was, well, you got some clips to play, do you not? I actually haven't seen it yet. Let's watch the Unga.
So the first one I have right here is from Zelensky. On his beg tour for more money. And it's really funny. You know, well, let's watch this.
Even though humanity is failing on its climate policy objectives, this means that extreme weather will still impact the normal global life, and some evil state will also weaponize its outcomes. And when people in the streets of New York and other cities of the world went out on climate protest, we all have seen them. And when people in Morocco and Libya and other countries die as a result of natural disasters, and when islands and countries...
Is he trying to say
The earthquake. Is he saying the earthquake in Morocco that killed like hundreds of people, thousands of people, was caused by climate change? Is that, am I hearing that right?
You absolutely are. If you can, you know, translate his fucking horrible English. Where's this guy from? Ukraine?
It's actually insane. We've given this guy like all of our tax money because you think he would use it to like, I don't know, sound smarter.
Right. I mean, if you come to New York to do a UN national nation assembly, at least learn the fucking language of the state.
I mean, his I will say his English has gotten much better, but like, come on, you could have gotten like fucking Rosetta Stone with that money.
Oh, absolutely. The billions that we sent over there. I mean, at least a Duolingo subscription could have worked.
Fuck it. You know, Duolingo. I don't even know any of what is it? What are the other?
And like, the sponsors for today, Habibis, is Duolingo and Rosetta Stone. If you need to learn Arabic to, you know, fuck that woman that you're looking over. Not the person. I was going to say, don't get those mixed up. Ever.
You don't know. If anything, what you want to do is learn Arabic so you could sneak into Mecca and then take a selfie of yourself in front of the Kaaba doing LSD.
Or, you know, when you go look for the stone, the black stone, you're licking the asshole of the Kaaba.
Okay. When this gets like aired like 30 years from now, when I become the next caliph, I have to basically issue a condemnation of that. I condemn this wholeheartedly.
Not just a condemnation. You'd be like, okay, for the first order, I have to fatwa my second in command.
Yeah. After I avenged you against Carl, this is how you repay me, Jay? Fucking A. No, what I was going to say was that... I lost my train of thought. What was I going to say? It was something about Zelensky and with Duolingo to learn Arabic. I thought it'd be to sneak into the Kaaba, into Mecca and take a selfie in front of the Kaaba. Instead of praying to Allah, when you take the LSD, you're seeing him.
Right there in front of you. That's 100% what will happen. Man, honestly, I need to get you on LSD. It's fucking fantastic. Imagine doing a whole, because we're on Rumble, I think we could do a whole show on LSD. I don't think they will
cut it out. How do the Habibis who are watching this right now not know if we're on LSD right now?
They wouldn't.
Actually, that's true. Because we probably wouldn't even know that the show is right. On.
Yeah. Fuck. But to get back to this, I mean, it is absolutely fucking hilarious that he is scripted on using the buzzwords he needs to use in order to try and make himself look like this moral authority. So people will throw more money at him and have the media question it, because the media cannot question the climate dogma and people who prophesize it. They don't question it. I mean, from when 2002, when Al Gore first set foot where he is right now and promised, he fucking promised us. And I'm still pissed that the promise didn't come through, that in 2014, New York would be underwater. Do you know how much cleaner America would be with New York underwater?
Then everyone
that would be
Jay. Legal? Yeah. Just think about it, Jay. Then the whole city will be filled with wetbacks. Okay, that was making a joke about how there's so many migrants in New York City.
In New York right now.
And New York is tripling. It's crippling.
But it's hilarious. And like, what does this have to do with Russia? What does any of this have to do with defending Ukraine?
I'm hoping he's going to get to the point, Jay. Maybe we should. It looks like we're not even still halfway through the clip.
Yeah, there's still like a minute.
Let's go.
Disappear underwater, and when tornadoes and deserts are...
Tornadoes. You know what he sounds like? He sounds like my Lebanese father yelling
at me. I was literally about to say.
He's kind of about to be like, we need hundreds of thousands and shut your mouth.
Thousands. Shut the hell up your mouth.
Spreading into new territories. And when all of this is happening, one, a natural disaster in Moscow decided to launch a big war and kill tens of thousands of people. We have to stop it.
That lisp is just too much.
We must act united to defeat the aggressor and focus all our capabilities and energy on addressing these challenges.
Okay, hold on. Who's the aggressor when it comes to climate change? Who's the aggressor? Normal human beings? You know, a mother with a gas stove? A mother with a van taking her kids to soccer practice?
Not even a mother with any of those things. Literally just a mother just procreating. They want to...
Right.
Because having a kid is bad for climate change.
Or like what we were saying last show, you know, big fat black Lizzos who just throw methane out in the atmosphere every other day after they have dinner. I mean, this is bad for us. Very bad for us.
What's so wild about it is that it's in this speech, he's talking about how climate change is like an existential threat. But I'm getting really fucked here by Russia, guys. Like, can you fucking do something? Like, mm-hmm. it almost sounds like I was going to bet that he was saying that climate change did this to Ukraine.
Right. He was about to get, well, he's trying to bridge that gap, saying like climate change is the aggressor and Russia is the aggressor and blah, blah, blah. But they say these things and they sit here in front of the United Nations where people are funneling millions and billions of dollars to do no good in the world. And he has China and he sits here and talks a big game. If you want to talk about the aggressor on climate change, if climate change is the existential threat to humanity, as you all like to claim, none of them bring up China. None of them say anything about China. Instead, they say that you need to do your part. That's right. Not going to do anything. It's really not going to do it. I mean, I was just looking at the carbon emissions by country, mm-hmm. and we're at 14%. China is at 39%. India is at 20-something percent. Everyone else is
at the U.S. is at 14. U.S. is at
14%. Yeah, China is at 39%.
And
India probably, is at 24%.
Yeah.
Yes.
So
and then like the UK and all of these other ones are like 1%, 2%, you know, somewhere around there. So what is going to make the UK who does 1% carbon neutral going to do about the 35% coming out of fucking China? How's that going to stop it?
Jay, I've always contended that the best solution to climate change, well, if you want to talk about a geopolitical solution, the first way would be to invade every country and make it America, because then you can actually make the world submit to your will, your caliphate. Sharia law, which, by the way, I'm sure a lot of our viewers would probably prefer an entire world dominated by Sharia law over what we're currently seeing. I just feel like things have gotten so bad. People are like, you know what? Let's give that Sharia a try.
I know. It's really funny because you have people like Matt Walsh and stuff like that actually saying there's some aspect of Sharia law that we need to get back into.
All you really need is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, and Matt Walsh is basically Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi.
Right. I mean, he has the beard for it, and
he has the beard for it. He already has like the sort of the mental preparedness and willingness to act in that way. Pretty much from day one. I would say he is like literally the Shahada away from being like the front runner for being the next caliph of Islam. It's really just that.
Honestly, it sounds like it too. He sounds like one too. Like he's very, it's because of the conviction he has when he's speaking, like a religious person usually does when they're giving a sermon. He has that when he speaks. So you just put a turban on him and give him a little bit of an Arabic accent, and he'll sound like the imam that we had in Oklahoma.
Honestly, I feel like I should invite Matt Walsh to the show, because I really would like to just like...
Oh, that would be so great. Honestly, it would be great to have him on the show.
I might be able to get him on the show. We'll see what happens. That'd be wild. No, that would be a lot of fun. Jay, if anything, my main solution to climate change And I say this to climate activists all the time. Like, you really want to do the most you possibly can to reverse the harsh effects of climate change. Kill yourself. I mean, like, literally, I don't mean in the leak, like, I hope you kill yourself. Like, I hope you, you know, something bad happens to you. Like, no, like, it's as simple as that. If you don't want to contribute to the destruction of our planet, humans are some of the biggest carbon emitters. Stop it at its source. So kill yourself. Of course, disclaimer, I'm not actually telling you to kill yourselves, but I will say it is known to work. And yeah, but well, it's interesting, instead of them dying, though, however, they want you to suffer, they want you to die. So
right, and they
it's
go
anything
and
they anything about- it's fighting back, and you're only fighting back with your words. And then we can say the stuff on Rumble, of course.
Yeah. Oh no, of course we can. A lot of things are free for us to say up here, but it's really funny that they want to tell the Western world to sacrifice so much and sacrifice having kids, sacrifice, you know, your kids having air conditioner, sacrifice
and
them
having
proper
kids.
Yeah, proper sacrifice your family from having like proper freezers, all of that kind of stuff in the tune of barely making a dent in comparison to what they're allowing happen in China. There, and make no mistake, they are allowing this stuff to happen. Like, this is an existential threat. This is supposedly killing hundreds of thousands of people. This is worse.
Every year.
This is supposed to be worse than any war that any country can perpetrate. And China's the biggest perpetrator of climate change. And we do nothing about it. There's no sanctions. There's no like trying to get them off of it. There's no repercussions. There's nothing.
Well, hold on, Jay. Building more now. Stop right there. Unless you're low on Boebert, you're getting someone off of it, or at least getting someone off. Not a segue, by the way. Go back to the we had from locals. This is what happens when you get on the locals non-pores chat, which we have running on our locals. If you hit that join button. Cold Beer 69, Imam in Oklahoma, McVeigh was framed. Thank you, Cold Beer 69.
Oh man, that was
like we found. Imagine if they pinned the Oklahoma City bombing on Matt Walsh after that.
No, I mean, McVeigh didn't have that great what's it called? That great beard like he did.
I don't know. Didn't they blame Muslims initially, or I think did they blame Islamic terrorists for the Oklahoma City bombing at first, just because it was like less than 2 years or 2 years removed from the 93 World Trade Center bombing.
Yes.
So, yeah, Islamic terrorism was alive and well. We just really it came to the forefront, I think, on 9/11 2001. That's when everybody knew about it, as opposed to only like people who are like in the know. Wow, we really went off a tangent there. Fry Piper on Rumble says, okay, that's really Canadian of you, Siraj. Which part? I would like to know.
I know there's a lot. Is it about him being gay?
Because that is all of Canada.
Right. And that's all Siraj. So that's very Canadian.
And that's all Siraj. I guess that's very
that's I think we should dub that now. When somebody's being gay, when one of your friends are being gay or anything like that, you just say that's very Canadian of you. You're being very Canadian right now. Stop being Canadian.
Stop being Canadian. Oh, Ben says it's the suicide thing.
Okay, that makes it even funnier because there's no context there. What's it?
What really is
or suicide? Oh, the medical. They're.
Medical.
Yes. So you walk in with like a broken finger. They're like, okay, kill yourself. I have depression. Okay, kill yourself. Hey, my grandmother's having breathing problems. She's old. Kill her.
Kill
her. Like, that is how the Canadian healthcare system works.
It's actually amazing horrible. That anyone still lives in Canada. You know, having a lot of Canadian colleagues, I think it's fascinating hearing their perspective on American politics. And some of them, know their stuff. Others, not as well, but that's okay because some of them don't need to know it in order to do their jobs. But I will say this, a lot of them who previously didn't care about politics have basically become radicalized. And that's just kind of funny how everything, their perspective on what pisses them off is more so about, I feel like American politics pisses them off more than Canadian politics, because with Canadian politics, they just resign themselves to being like, yeah, it's fucking Trudeau. What are you going to do?
No, but it's because we're more free. We're still a little bit more free here. So that's why they hate it. They want us to be as authoritarian as they are. And while under the guise of being liberal, right. That's what they want. So we have a couple more videos here coming out from.
Sorry. Let me get to that. How much time was left on that one?
That one was done.
Oh, really? Wow. Okay.
Yeah, there's like 2 seconds left.
This is what happens. This is what happens when I have caveman internet and I don't produce the show because my upload speed's terrible.
Right.
You may notice the backdrop of Habibi's. I'm in a foreign place, and yes, I moved to a temporary cave in Afghanistan. That's also why my internet's so terrible. Yes, I am in Afghanistan.
So this was actually from last year, but it's making the rounds on Twitter again. And this was the previous New Zealand prime minister.
Oh yeah, and Jacinda Ardern.
Right, and this is when she came on, and this was the height of COVID.
Okay.
And they wanted to talk. About free speech and about misinformation, basically. And it's really, I mean, just listen to her.
This week, we launched an initiative alongside companies and nonprofits to help improve research and understanding of how a person's online experiences are curated by automated processes. This will also be important in understanding more about mis and disinformation online, a challenge that we must, as leaders, address. Sadly, I think it's easy to dismiss this problem as one in the margins. I can certainly understand the desire to leave it to someone else. As leaders, we're rightly concerned that even the most light-touch approaches to disinformation could be misinterpreted.
Why does every South Asian man look like that they molested somebody on the way to work?
As being hostile to the values of free speech that we value so highly.
Well, Beer 69 on Local says, when did horses get a seat at the UN?
It's the buck teeth, baby. No bucks.
I actually didn't notice that. Look at that. Those are some chompers. You know, look, I'm not going to make fun of anyone's appearance. I think that's low. And I think it's obviously
beneath us.
Beneath us. That being said, how are politicians like some of the most like not even the ones who are in politics, but like the ones who specifically are like trying to destroy this country look like they're super villains?
That's a really good question. You know who she looks like when you say that, like with her buck teeth? Hold on. I'll bring it up.
I'm scared. I'm so scared. Don't you do this to me, Jay. Jay's looking for this clip. He's going to jump to a different tab. Or is he going to boomer this shit? I think he's going to boomer it. He definitely boomered it. Look at his face. He fucking boomered it so badly. He was going to share the tab, but instead, like, closed the tab, and now he's going back to going to find it. Tell me I'm lying, Jay. Tell me I'm lying.
No, you're lying.
See, that's bullshit. That's cat. Okay.
No, you're not. Hold on. Wait 1 second.
Jesus, he totally Christ. Boomered this shit. Totally boomers this shit. I'm not the only boomer.
I hit. Yeah. Stop sharing this tab. Sorry.
I want you to meet yourself. Like.
Oh.
Especially when she yells.
You just gotta like pause it right in the middle. So it just.
Honestly, this movie was so... Jeez.
Send in the guys!
Boots on me.
In the club!
Begin the countdown.
5, 4!
Begin the countdown at 30.
30, 29.
It looks exactly like her. You can't say she does it.
She does. Go back to the Jacinda. Yeah, I could see it. Totally. Let's hear this.
Today, what the answer is to this challenge, I can say with complete certainty that we cannot ignore it. To do so poses an equal threat to the norms we all value. After all, how do you successfully end a war?
Hold on, Jay.
To believe the reason for its existence is not...
Still would.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Not only legal, but noble. How do you tackle climate change if people do not believe it exists? How do you ensure the human rights of others are upheld when they are subjected to hateful and dangerous rhetoric and ideology? The weapons may be different, but the goals of those who perpetuate them is often the same: to cause chaos and reduce the ability of others to defend themselves, to disband communities, to collapse the collective strength of countries who work together. But we have an opportunity here to ensure that these particular weapons of war do not become an established part of war.
She's claiming words are weapons of war.
What?
Yes.
No.
Yep. She's claiming that words are weapons of war. And it's really amazing, like, the way the governments of the world were throwing this in our faces and just doing it nonchalantly. And the media were silent about it. Like, the media is supposed to be there for the little guy. But what did the media do? CNN would go after a grandmother for sharing a meme on Facebook instead of hold these people accountable or hold Facebook accountable for actually giving information to the FBI or working with the FBI to silence a story. CNN will go after a grandmother for sharing a meme on Facebook instead. Or CNN will go after a GIF maker and threaten him to never make GIFs again. Instead of actually going after these people and the words that they're spewing, and also the intent behind them. There's no such thing as good intentions with these people. Like, the thing I hate the most, and I repeat it again and again, is when there are people, either people in other publications that like to say that people on the left have good intentions when they are trying to push certain policies. This is false. They do not have good intentions. This is not about saving the trans community or saving gay people, or, you know, you can't make fun of that guy for, you know, sucking dick. No, it's not about that. It's about controlling what it is we can and cannot say and what they will allow you to know. That's the key. Not what you can and cannot say, what they will allow you to know.
So, yeah, you bring up a good point about what they will and will not allow, but specifically on the point about, like, making fun of people sucking dick. Like, look, the only people you can make fun of sucking dick are people who suck dick or don't suck dick. So that's everyone. I don't know, even though
that reminds me of, like, the asshole dick. You know what I mean? I want to be a dick instead of being an asshole. I'd rather be a dick. Asshole shits on everybody, but a dick, a dick fucks an dicks. Asshole.
Yeah, it's the
fuck from, assholes.
It's from Team America. It's like, you got your dicks, your pussies, and your assholes. Like, you know, you got your dicks, and they just want to fuck everything. They just want to fuck up all the time. And pussies, you know, they get fucked, like, by dicks. And then assholes, you got your assholes out here, and they just shit all over everything. But dicks also fuck assholes. And what happens, you know what happens when you don't fuck, when dicks don't fuck assholes? You have your dicks and your pussies all covered in shit. That had to be the
genius, man. Absolute geniuses. They are so good. They need to make another movie.
I don't know why I have memorized that entire monologue, but that
it's because your pussy and asshole get fucked by dicks.
My bussy, Jay. My bussy and my asshole are the same, you know?
Oh, man. Yeah, fuck this bitch. All right, let's see. What's the next one? So now we're going to have our grand leader. Honestly, it's so amazing seeing this guy on the main stage. Absolutely. I mean, the confidence that he brings out as a leader.
I don't know what I'm trying to do here.
Simply put, the 21st century, results are badly needed, are needed to move us along. That starts with the United Nations, starts right. Simply put.
Wait, hold on. I feel like I'm reaching like Joe Biden levels of mental cognitive dysfunction because I don't understand a word he fucking said.
I didn't understand anything.
Did you understand?
No. Nothing. You know what this guy looks like? Hmm. Or who he looks like? Hold on. I don't know if you remember this.
Okay. This guy. Oh yeah, the Crypt Keeper. Yeah, that's what it was called, right?
I mean, yeah, because it's so funny. When I was growing up, these type of things were not allowed in the UAE. Like anything with Halloween, anything ghost or demon, demonic, whatever, you're not allowed until I first came here. But he looks exactly like this guy. Like, it is fucking insane.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
But, I mean, you have the leaders of the fucking world here. The leaders of the world are here, and the media wants to pretend that Trump was more of an embarrassment than watching this, than seeing this guy, like how weak he is. I mean,
he's making us dumber. Like, it's not even like that. That's I think people don't realize, like, we used to be a country that produced like intellects and we had, you know, academia was something to be valued, something to actually be something that we actually appreciated and sought. And now we've come to the point where, because people valued these things, that the practitioners of these within these institutions felt like they could get away with a lot more shit than they should be allowed to. And I think a lot of people, the wool has been lifted over their eyes, and all of a sudden they can't fool anyone anymore. Everyone's got cell phones. Everyone can record what's happening in their classes. They can record anyone out on the campuses, and it's bled over into the corporate world too. Like, all of these woke, I hate saying the word woke, all of these retards are out here basically saying, like, that, you know, white is black and black is white and down is up, up is down. And they're getting away with this shit. Like, they're getting away with it. And people let it continue to happen, because if they say anything, then their entire lives are ruined. And that fat girl with the blue hair says she's going to slit your throat and probably, you know, rape your wife, because that girl with the blue hair is actually a guy because with a dick.
Right. And it's also a thing. I would like to say what we did wrong was that we gave too much credit to academia and too much credit to the experts. Especially within media, where we allowed them to just come up and spew random bullshit for coin and try to set narratives and agendas. When you have an expert, you can't no longer believe experts that come onto news shows. Yeah. You can't expect them, because a lot of them skew either the graphs, skew the statistics, skew the facts, skew the skew them into a narrative to force feed you. And when we saw that happen, I think people have been banging that drum. I mean, you had Andrew Breitbart, for instance, who banged that drum against the media strongly, saying that the media is in cahoots with the political parties and they're here to push narratives on you.
Were you the one who originally told, I think you may have said it on the show, were you the one who originally said that you think Andrew Breitbart was murdered?
Or something? Well, that was one of our guests. Because the thing is I got here after Andrew Breitbart was murdered. So I never knew about him or really looked into it a lot until I got here. And I started realizing and noticing that the media is not forthcoming. They lie by omission. And they also skew a lot of the facts on purpose. And while they were doing that, I started researching more into alternative media, and I started researching more into people who were, you know, against mainstream media. And Andrew Breitbart came to the forefront, especially with the Tea Movement and all of that kind of stuff as well. You know,
the Tea Party.
Sorry. So, like one of his famous ones with the Tea Party was, They were claiming that the protesters were saying the N-word. So he would go around.
Well, Jay, that's because it's the Tea Movement, okay?
He would go around all the media circuits and ask them to showcase and bring the video of them saying the N-word. If you're reporting on it, you can certainly bring proof. And he also put out an award, and nobody came forward with it. Nobody could produce that. He was the first one to talk about Anthony Weiner being a pedo. And you had people like Chris Hayes famously defend Weiner like he was the one sucking Weiner's dick. Like, it was fucking insane. And then
are you sure that was Chris Hayes or Rachel Maddow? I can never tell anymore.
So when Chris Hayes is sucking dick, he's gay. But Maddow is when he's a lesbian getting pegged by other women.
No,
that's his persona.
Or pegged, I guess.
Yeah, that's his persona. Either way, he's still the gay guy getting fucked. But then that started opening my eyes a little bit more and better when it came to the media. And now you just see expert after expert just flat out lie with zero pushback on any of it. We still don't see MSNBC or CNN have those experts back on and talk to them about masks being completely fucking useless. Or talk to them about the vaccine not it's being 100% effective on transmission, essentially.
You can already tell, though, that they're people are, you know, they're rolling out the vaccine again. They just got FDA approval on it, right? And they also got the all the masks coming back. It's fucking happening all over again. And Jay, you're coughing in the middle of this, which makes me think you have COVID, in which case put on a fucking mask and stay 6 feet the fuck away from me.
No, I don't. I'm good. And then we have a neocon for Rand Paul. Thank you very much for the dollar rumble Rand with cloth off.
I feel like someone else has to make a dono in order for us to like to confirm the initial purchase.
It's close. Yeah. So
that it's like you want, you're just saying cloth off, or are you saying like you want our shirts off? Because if you want our shirts
off, you got to clarify. Sorry.
You could either tell us in the locals premium chat and not have to donate any extra, or you could submit you tell us. But I realize that someone within the locals chat is definitely going to say, take your shirts off, and we're going to have to.
And then we're going to have to. Sorry. Locals
chat. Probably. Our viewership is probably going to get cut in half, which honestly, fair. I get it.
Yeah, I understand. I totally understand.
Pilot Smith says cloth on. Cloth on. Wow. Okay, we gotta listen to the Habibis on locals. Oh, now here comes.
Oh, thank you for
Neocon for Rand Paul.
They say Joe Bob's.
All right.
Okay, hold on. I got him. Hold on. No, I got Bob. He said,
wait, Joe who's Bob?
I'm going. He said, "Show Bob."
I'm getting Bob.
I'm getting Bob.
You're getting Bob. Okay, I'll put my shirt back on. Bob the Builder, right?
That's Bob. It's Bob's. Bobby boy. Oh, man. And then while he's getting his shirt back on, here's our fearless leader again.
Oh, perfect.
Now, he has to involve our institutions and drive. Let me be clear. Certain principles are in the national system. Now, he has to involve our institutions and drive creative new partnerships. Let me be clear. Certain principles are in the national system are sacrosanct.
Bro.
We evolve our institutions and drive creative new partnerships. Let me be clear. Certain principles
are in the national system. His dentures are fucking falling out.
Sacrosanct. Now, we as we evolve our institutions and drive creative new partnerships. Let me be clear. Certain principles are in the national system.
I feel like this clip needs to be sent to there's this group of DJs. Uh-huh. It's a pair, and they take certain sayings and quotes and then put a beat or a drop in it and make it sound like techno or disco or whatever. So they need this. It's like, let me be clear. Yes, that's exactly what it is. Laura Banks coming in, and honestly, I think this is the best. This is the best subtitles that we could have for it. That's exactly what he said.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for that contribution. Now
he has to evolve.
it's so sad. It's so sad that he's up there talking to the leaders of the world and nobody would understand. Like, imagine being a translator for this guy in Arabic. Oh, you know, and I'm like some shit-faced Arabic translator.
You're like,
trying to say this, and I'll be like, I'll just be cursing in Arabic. Yeah, exactly.
Be like, oh, kusamak. How you say
It's so sad.
69 says the Obama translator Key and Peele schedule is legendary. We need to buy them one.
All right. Man, but it's just going to be some white guy in the background be like, I don't know what the fuck this guy's saying.
I watched the shit out of that.
I think that would be hilarious.
You know, also, Jay, I couldn't stop watching the shit out of over this past weekend.
What?
Beetlejuice the musical. In fact, I went and came. Actually, I went three times and I came six.
Did you go by yourself or did you go with Boebert? Is it Boebert? 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 Boebert. Boebert. You went with Boebert.
What the fuck is that?
Is it Boebert?
No, I went by myself, Jay.
Oh, sorry. Huh. I was just asking because, you know, Representative Lauren Boebert likes to give a little
OTPHJ.
She likes to take a little beef jerky to
a little over a little over a little over the pants handy, if you will.
Yeah, if you will. I mean, instead of popcorn, it's a little beef jerk.
A sweet little heege, a little heege in action.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the
so she gave a hand job to her date to in the theater this past
I want to know what Beetlejuice. Hey, I need to know what is in this Beetlejuice musical because it sounds hot as fuck.
I think people just get horny watching.
Yo, who is making Beetlejuice
that's this what's horny? Happening. But she did release, for the Habibis who haven't watched it, she did release a statement after the Beetlejuice.
Did you already play the video, Jay?
No, I haven't played it yet, but I'll show you right now. Here it is.
Bring it up to my place. You realize it. Yeah, I know you can. Bring it up to my place. You don't know what you need to me.
So that was that's what happened the past weekend at Beetlejuice, and so after that was released, right. She released a statement, and do you want me to read it or do you want to read it?
All right, I'll read it. The past few days have been difficult and humbling, and I'm truly sorry for the unwanted attention my Sunday evening in Denver has brought to the community. While none of my actions or words as private citizen that night were intended to be malicious or meant to cause harm, the reality is that they did, and I regret that. I don't know who wrote this shit, but definitely wasn't her. There's no perfect blueprint for going through a public and difficult divorce, which over the past few months has made for a more challenging personal time for me and my entire family. So I give hand jobs to people who go to Beetlejuice with me. I've tried to handle it. She gets it. I've tried to handle it with strength, and grace, I'm sure, as best as I can, but simply fell short of my values on Sunday. That means he didn't come, or he came too quick.
It's one or the other. I think he touched the boob for the first time, and it just blew.
Anyway, she says that's unacceptable, and I'm sorry. Look, I don't have to read the rest of it. I think what's interesting about it is that she says she's sorry. And I honestly, I'm kind of surprised she doesn't say, like, suck my dick, I'd do it again, fuck you, and then run that shit. That's honestly, I'd have a lot more respect for that.
Yeah, I would too. I'd just be like, bro, it was night and I went and, you know, gave a handy in the back. What you tell me? Never done some shady shit.
Let he who has not given a handy during Beetlejuice the musical throw the first stone. That's right.
We are all without sin.
That's right.
Oh no, with sin. We are none without.
We've all done this. We've all done this.
We've all been whores. It's happened.
Essentially 100%.
No, but what was really fucking hilarious about this, where it was, there was this one guy, I forget his name on Twitter, but he has a pretty big Twitter following, Chris or something, and they wanted to make it out to be like the LGBTQ community, like they were the real victims here, saying like, can you imagine if this was two gay guys doing this or whatever?
I do remember seeing
and
that,
and trying to,
We're talking about it now.
Right. But no,
literally talking about it now. It's this happened like several days ago, and they're talking about, if this were like a gay couple, this would be the talk of the town and blow up everywhere. Like, no, mm-hmm. Like gay, we know that's the Pride Parade happens every year. Like, do you think that there aren't like dudes giving each other blowies in the alley? And that's just like when it's, you know, a Tuesday in New York City in September. You know, and it's cold out, and unfortunately Chick-fil-A is closed. And so, you know, some stranger comes up to you and offers you an extra Chick-fil-A sandwich, and you lock eyes as your hands slowly touch. Mm. And that's when it happened. The magic moment. Anyways, Jay, what I have to say about this Lauren Boebert thing. I still think they're fucking, you know, I don't think this is the end. I actually, no joke, I shit you not, Jay, I did a radio hit, a Denver radio hit earlier today talking about, I haven't told anybody, I don't actually advertise when I go on the radio. It's actually kind of funny. But my bold prediction, she says she broke up with this guy because he's like a bar owner who like ran drag shows and he's like a Democrat. I don't think that's where it ends. I think both parties are looking at each other and like, I can fix her or him. I think that's where. Whoa. I think that's where.
If you looked at the video footage, yeah, you can tell she was the more dominant one. He's the lib because she took his hand and he's like fucking. She's like fucking like grope me. What the fuck is wrong with you? Are you gay? Fucking grope me, you fucking lib.
Yeah,
you can always tell that that's the dynamic between the two. Like when I was over there visiting, I could tell that you were more of a lib than your wife because of how your wife dominates you.
Well, bro,
you can always tell who the bottom is, who the lib bottom is in a relationship.
Hey Jay, when have you ever heard of the man being the woman being the dominant one in a relationship and the man being accused of like domestic violence? Never. It's always the woman accused. I'm safe. No one can ever accuse me of domestic violence.
Also, because people knew your dynamic. If people knew your dynamic and Emily was like, yeah, he beats me, everybody would be like, what? No, he
doesn't. No, he doesn't.
He's like, too scared. He would piss his pants before he does that.
What's so funny about it is that she totally would just like, everyone would be like, no, there's no way, because Emily would definitely just, Emily just beats the shit out of you.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's so funny to watch.
I bet she's like overhearing this in the other room being like,
oh, somebody's going to get his ass whooped tonight. Absolute beat.
Hey, make sure you explain to her. Make sure you explain to her at my funeral what actually happened.
Oh yeah, as we were talking about this, yeah, of course.
Thank
you.
Like,
how many times I tell you not to bring me up?
Yeah.
So good.
So yeah, but that's again. We thought this is funny. I don't know if this is being done as a means of like distracting us from, you know, the Biden impeachment inquiry, which was opened up, by the way. I mean, we didn't even fucking talk about that. I guess because
wait.
Jay, we're desensitized.
We'll put on the what's it called? The aluminum hats. What you're saying is that her lib boyfriend is actually a Fed, and this is all a
psyop. Oh shit. This really is, it's a distraction tool because she has to be like heavily involved in the impeachment inquiry. Or she was possibly going to be selected by the House Speaker as being a part of the impeachment inquiry, which now that she's been outed in this regard, yes, she would not be selected because people would be like, why the fuck is Lauren Boebert on the impeachment inquiry panel? Didn't she just give a handy to some lib out in Aspen, Colorado, watching fucking Beetlejuice? And everyone would be like, yes, what the fuck are you doing, House Speaker McCarthy? And McCarthy would be like, I'm so sorry. She didn't give me a hand job in the Beetlejuice musical. So okay, I'm sorry, Lauren. You can't do this. I'm taking you off. I'm benching you.
That's exactly what's going to happen. Exactly what's going to happen. And talking about missing hand jobs, the F-35 fighter jet that was missing, if for the Habibis who don't know about this, is one of the wildest stories that you're going to hear this week. So apparently the Navy has lost an F-35 stealth fighter jet after the pilot, surprisingly named Ahmed El-Filnani, ejected.
No out. Fucking way was his name that.
No, it wasn't.
Oh. Oof, nearly got me there.
I should have kept it going. Oh my God, that would have been amazing. his name has not been released yet, but it was this is no joke. This actually happened. So he did an ejection out of the what's it called? The cockpit. He was probably watching the Beetlejuice in theater.
He's like, yeah, he's like,
he ejaculated out of the cockpit.
Let's make this cockpit explode, daddy.
So he ejected out of it, and apparently the stealth mode was still on or something because they completely lost the jet, and they lost it for like the whole day. Like, it was flying still, lost. Nobody knew where it was, and they finally found it. They finally found it 80 miles from Joint Base Charleston, South Carolina.
Here, can you zoom in on that?
Ran through a group of trees.
Jay, no one can see that.
You can see.
There you go.
That's where the wreckage was. Honestly, it looks like a missile.
Honestly,
It's a, you know, the Pentagon degrees.
I was literally about to say, is that where United Flight 93 went?
That's where it landed. So yeah, I went through all the trees and it landed. And I like how they're saying it's unknown what caused the crash. No pilot. I don't know. The pilot ejected out of it.
Who would have thought? Maybe he just wanted to live. Maybe he just wanted to live on the wild side and just like, you know what? Fuck it. YOLO ejects out of that.
I can't believe he just did it for the lulz. They're hiring Afghanis as pilots now.
Jay, I have you know that my culture is not their goddamn $80 million
project. Oh, man, it's way too good. This is crazy. Crazy how that kind of shit just could happen like that.
Yeah, I'd say it's... we live in a weird time. And also, Jay, I don't know if you know about this, but Susan Collins, the senator from Maine, she's about to absolutely fucking she's gonna make me fall in love with her.
Right. Well, especially because this is in response to what's it called? The new change in rules that what's his name made?
John Fetterman.
Yes. Well, not John Fetterman. It was
they made the rule change in the Senate.
Yes, they made a rule change to accommodate Fetterman, because Fetterman is a fucking slob, and also brain damage.
Cosplaying as a blue collar worker. Don't forget that, Jay. So right. Susan Collins says she's going to wear a bikini tomorrow, which I greatly appreciate that. And we might actually get a preview in the... Oh, yeah. Look at them. Look at that milk. Look at that aged milk right there. Repost.
Milk time.
Actually, Jay, guilty time.
That's what that is. Please don't.
I'm a guilt hunter. I'm a guilt hunter, Jay. You didn't know that about me? That's right. I like to...
No, because he commented, please don't. So I'm like, okay, block. This is not the type of guy I want in my feed. it's gonna be hilarious because I'm gonna have like a post go viral and the guy's gonna be like, why am I blocked by this guy? I've never interacted with him. I love that shit.
That is an amazing reason to block somebody, is just to do it to confuse the shit out of them.
Where do I go to my settings on who I blocked? Because I think he's the only guy I blocked.
Jay, I'll let you find that before you like spill out your entire password to everyone.
Oh, and everything. Oh no, I'm playing. I'm not gonna look for it. But it's fucking hilarious that I mean, we had all of these people whine and cry about norms and absolutely say nothing about these norms being completely shat on. And they're being shat on just to make sure Fetterman's not sad, to accommodate Fetterman
because they can't tell him. Because did they say like depression is basically for him, that's like why he's not like showing up to work or some shit?
No, the reason why, they're trying to play it off like he has depression.
He's got the sads. Actually,
he suffered a stroke, and the guy's mental capacity is as much as, you know, the shit I take when I have Taco Bell. And they want to accommodate him wearing this stuff because of the stroke he had. That's why he wears tennis shoes. That's why he can't dress himself. That's why all of that kind of stuff happens. They need to, I mean, his wife is 5'1" because she's Mexican, and he is like a fucking gorilla. And okay, for her to be able to dress him into a suit and tie easily. So they had to accommodate it because they won't call for him to resign as he should, because he's mentally incapable of doing his job. Same thing with Dianne Feinstein. Same thing with Mitch McConnell. Same thing with any of these guys that are above 76 years old. They don't have the mental capacity to do their job.
It's a good chunk of them, Jay. It's a good chunk of them. Master Thief, and I might be able to share this. Master Thief on Locals. I want to show you guys the... It says, make them wear this on the Senate floor. Vote by mail.
Oh.
And it's the fucking Unabomber.
Oh, my God. Ted, I want that shirt. Ted, fuck, I want that shirt, too.
That's that's such a baller shirt, because
that is,
you know, anybody who recognizes that will come up to you and either be like, what the fuck are you doing? Or they'll come up to you and be like, based.
Yeah, it's one or the other. That's how it would be. That is fucking amazing.
Very good. Amazing. Very good. So I have to say, Jay, that everything in respect to Fetterman.
You know how the Habibi Bros would go to the Senate?
Yep. Fucking beautiful, Jay. Jay, you just know a great fucking segue. Holy shit.
Thank you, Fetterman. Because this is how the Habibi Bros would be. Thank you, Fetterman. Coming. Yep. Yeah, this is how I'm gonna cast my vote.
I'm gonna go in. I'm gonna give one squeeze for nay, two squeezes for yay. Jay, can you give all those in favor? Say aye. Oh fuck! Yay!
Aye. And then we do something wrong, and I just feel like, I'm sorry.
Sorry. Actually, I'm gonna vote present. John Fetterman on Twitter, responding to Fox News, says, I figure if I take up vaping and grabbing the hog during a live musical, they'll make me a folk hero. Which, look, touche.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, for the most part, but nobody was really making her out to be a hero or, you know, defending her actions in any way. I don't think
who's making her out to be a hero. I think everybody, I think all of us were like, yeah, she's trashy,
right? Like the whole thing was trash.
Yeah. We got some videos to react to, don't we, Jay? Do you have them ready?
Wait, what videos to react to? Where are they? Other videos to react to. Got it. I have them right here. I have them. Hold on.
I give you this one task, and all you do.
No, I have them.
Fuck me right in the ass, Jay.
Fuck yeah.
All right, let me go get Ernie.
Go get Ernie, and I'll get these queued up. And Habibis, you can ask your questions, because this would be Ask Us Anything right now, too. We'll get it done. The fried Piper, what's with his ridiculous mustache? I don't know. Apparently it was some kind of bet between him and somebody else, and he lost the bet, so he has to do it. Looks like an old pick of the original Fetterman. Yes, that is an old pick, because Fetterman has a mustache now. Joshin, why does Siraj have bikini strap tan lines? Well, because he wears a onesie when he goes to the beach. The fried Piper. Piper. So Siraj just revealed he wasn't wearing any pants just now. I didn't pay attention to that. I don't know if he walked out with no pants or not, but I'm not wearing any pants either. I mean, I do this show all the time with no pants on. Usually I came just primed and ready. Neocon for Rand Paul. He couldn't dress himself before he had a stroke. This is true. This is true. Some people say that I look like Fetterman, but I don't see it. I don't see it at all. At all. Boxer briefs, always. That's what I wear too. So Master Thief over on the local or chat. Next Habibi game night. Yes, we are. We're in talks and doing it either Thursday night or Sunday night. We're gonna try and pick a good time frame to do it. For the Habibis who don't know, we do game night usually in the theme of like Jackbox games, which is a really nice party game you can do online and you can do with multiple people in random places. And if you join our Discord server, you can actually join us on game night. And then we stream it live for everyone to watch as well. Neocon for Rand Paul. Jay, did you see the video of Fetterman walking around an airport? Yeah, we actually have that queued up too. So that's going to be fun. And Siraj is back. Habibi. Hey, Master Thief was on Locals asking when the next Habibi game night is. And I was telling him it's either going to be Thursday night or maybe Sunday night, depending on what we have going on.
We could probably do it this Thursday night.
I'm down. So Thursday night, 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern, we're going to do game night. So whoever wants to sign up for it in our Discord server, just hit up Ben and let him know if you're ready. We have room for about 8 players for each of the different games we're going to be playing that night. And tune in because it's going to be a lot of fun. But let's go ahead and go into some of these reaction videos.
Let's do it. I can't hear anything, Jay. I don't think you're sharing sound.
Oh.
You're doing sharing window again instead of tab.
Because yep. I'm every a boomer.
Boomer.
See, so this is what college does to your kids now. Like, it turns them into absolute fucking mush, hive mind garbage.
I was just going to say, this is what zero pussy does to a motherfucker.
That too, because they're desperate to try and get pussy. I bet you every one of these chads have been pushed into it because they wanted to get laid. That's like 100% what's happening here. Okay. And one thing I will never forgive climate change activists is lying to us about being dead by 2014 because these fuckers exist.
Imagine Gen Z would have been cut off at the before it could really blossom
exactly. into shit. And then this one right here, which is really great, is that we actually have live footage of Fetterman walking into.
There's a naked guy in the airport. Yes, there is. My man.
Based man right there. What a fucking chat. She's man, like, don't John record Fetterman. This. Don't record this. And he goes, there's a naked man. Fucking based. Based as fuck. That's what I'm talking about.
But the dude walking around naked is arguably the most based.
There's a naked guy in the airport.
He's like, yes, there is.
Why? Play that
you
shit.
You know what happened?
Here? Yes, there is.
This is what happened to Abdullah during the you know, you've been randomly selected for a more intense search in from the TSA. Walks around halfway through the cavity search.
There's a naked guy in the airport.
He's thinking about how he fit the whole fucking hand all the way to his elbow up his ass. You can tell. Look at that. That's a guy in thought who just had a huge hand, TSA hand, up his ass. You can tell.
That's actually a live day after TSA.
That's it right there. And then one of the most American-based things an American-based company did was Doritos.
Viral cheese pulling trend on TikTok has taken to new heights by one of the world's most popular tortilla chip makers. In Somerset, England, Doritos pulled off this pretty amazing stunt. It dunked a giant nacho into a tall pile of cheese to see how far it would stretch. And it didn't disappoint. The cheese spanned the length of almost 15 meters or 49 feet without snapping. Well, according to the World Talent Organization, it was indeed a world record. So all that effort.
Either Dorito chip or Bright Bird's hand coming out of the pants.
That is, bro, that is amazing. We could cure world hunger. We could do all that shit. No.
But let's, no. Dip fucking,
let's dip a fucking potato chip in a fucking bowl of cheese and see how far it stretches.
Fucking love it. I mean, instead of feeding like five families with that tortilla chip, that's what we did here.
Yeah, we're like, we're gonna throw it away and no one will ever be allowed to eat it. Not even the squirrels and birds. Fuck them. They're shot on sight.
Absolutely.
Shot on sight. All right. So what's next up, Jay?
So we got Harry Sisson.
Harry Scissors.
Yeah, Harry.
That's what Chris Hayes does to Rachel Maddow. It's a Harry Scissors.
It's a Harry Scissors. I like it. So this guy is paid by the DNC and also by your fucking tax dollars to lie to you on social media. And he lies to kids. But here's a really weird just praise of Biden for being able to lift his leg up.
Just out of curiosity for all the Trump supporters and Republicans, do you think that Donald Trump could do something like this? Like, do you think he could stand up and stretch like President Biden was? This is President Biden out in Delaware recently exercising with First Lady Jill Biden. And I saw this photo. It's like, Delaware, wow, that's pretty impressive for Joe Biden to be able to do that at 80 years old. And then I thought, like, does anybody really think that Trump could match this? Like, does anybody think that Trump could stretch like this? And also, do these Trump supporters think that Trump could ride a bike? Like, do you... Could you guys imagine that? And this photo proves a lot to me. Not only is Joe Biden more mentally fit to be president, but he's also more physically fit to be president. You know, Republicans always want to talk about Biden's fitness for president. I'm happy to have that conversation because Donald Trump recently said that we're going into World War III and that Biden's running against Obama. So he's clearly not mentally there. And the thought of-
No, he said World War II. You fucking idiot. You dumbass. Trump said World War II, not World War III. You loser. What a loser. I couldn't even get it right. Fucking dumbass.
Yeah, see, this is why we can't allow anyone, whatever Harry Sisson's age, to vote.
No, fuck that.
Like,
I mean,
what is that,
voting
like 12?
should be 26. Voting should be 26. That's it. You under 26, you can't vote. I think that's fair.
If you're considered part of the 18 to 24 demographic, no offense, but clearly, everyone in that age group is failing this country. So,
well, I mean, if we killed that age group off,
Team America, and therefore, you know, collective punishment should exist for a reason. So, I'm sorry, you're no longer allowed to vote.
Well, not only allowed to vote, they shouldn't be allowed to live. Because I'm sorry, climate change is a very big issue, and people, statistically, they will produce more carbon than during their lifespan than people 36 and older. So
Jay, you drive a hard bargain.
And I say, hey, we're here to save African children, baby. That's what we do here. So Harry, go kill yourself.
What happened in the rest? I mean, like the apart from the insane levels of dick riding here. It's truly remarkable to see paid shows. Do they ever get confronted about this stuff? I feel like no one sees these people in public because they know that if they saw like a Harry Sisson in public, like he would absolutely he would basically be thrown into a dumpster. I could see that totally.
Absolutely. You know, he gets picked on. And it was really funny also because there's another guy who does this, like his friend or his like gay lover. He was in his like brand new Audi talking about how great the economy is. and how people complain about the economy are like disconnected. It is fucking hilarious. While he's getting paid to say this random fucking garbage. It's just, it's sick. Yeah. These type of people disgust me. But yeah, that was the last video to react to. I don't
okay. That, well, where make sure Habibi's
from the Discord server.
Oh, that's okay. I was just gonna say, Habibi's, make sure you go ahead and since it's September, it's Childhood Cancer Awareness Month. Make sure you go into the link, the top link in our description, for the Give Kids a Chance Act to look into it. Obviously, we don't expect you to do much. Hopefully there's something, an easier way for you to notify your representative to vote on this, because obviously, as much as we hate politicians, we still kind of need them to get shit done. And this is like one of those times where it's like, okay, we shat on you guys for a whole hour and 15 minutes, a whole 69 minutes. And okay, now can you help us? But don't help us for like our sake, help us for the kids, okay? I know Jay and I are normally of like the Michael Jordan, fuck them kids type of mentality. After all, we did just tell the entire age group of 18 to 24 year olds to kill themselves. But
I mean, if they care about the climate, yes.
If they care about the climate. But like when it comes to like childhood cancer, like, no, you know, let it be the kids' decision, okay? We don't want cancer dictating the terms here.
If they're old enough to say that that they're a different gender and cut their dicks off at 8 years old, then they're old enough to kill themselves. I don't know what to say.
yeah, exactly. I think there was like a video somewhere I saw about someone doing, maybe I'll find this for our show Thursday if we end up not doing a gaming stream, but someone basically asking a bunch of people on the street, like, would you allow a 12-year-old to get a tattoo? And all these girls are saying, no, no, no.
Right.
And then he asks, would you allow a 12-year-old to get, hormone treatment and gender affirming care and allow them to transition? And they're all like, yes, because a child knows what they're, you know, a child knows, pretty sure they know what they are. And right. It's just like, and it's like a repetition of just like all of them saying yes. And I'll find it for Thursday at the very least. We'll do some gaming, but maybe in the first like 10, 15 minutes, we'll react to shit. So,
yeah, that's fine. I think that's fair.
But yes, Habibis, thank you all for tuning in tonight. Thank you to all the Habibis in the local chat. Thank you so much for tuning in and hanging with us. That includes Cold Beer 69, Master's Thief, Esquire, Kenan Hodges 8787. Who else did we get? We got Tyler Smith, Joshin. Who else? I'm looking through it. I know there's one more else. I think Wood Chipping.
Yes.
Wood Chipping was here for a bit and he dipped real quick. Yeah, I see Wood Chipping there. Yes, Habibis, thank you all so much for joining us. And we hope you tune in on Thursday. We're doing this every Tuesday and Thursday night, 10 p.m. East, 7 p.m. Pacific, live on Rumble. You can hear us on. We have this audio uploaded to all of the different podcasts. So subscribe to us on Apple Podcasts. Subscribe to us on Spotify. Leave a rating. Let Habibis know whether they can see us or not. Or they went blind because we take off our shirts, that they can still hear us on Apple Podcasts and Spotify and wherever else you
can get podcasts. Spread the message. Like, we spread Carl's mother's legs every Saturday night.
Booty cheeks.
Booty, booty, booty everywhere.
Rocking everywhere. That's actually, ironically, that's like one of my wife's favorite songs. And you probably...
Hopefully we didn't ruin it for
when we first met this, it was a fire song. I think it was Bubba Sparks, Miss New Booty, and she'd just be singing it all the time when we were in college. It was so funny. God. Habibis, thank you all so much. Thank you to Ben, our listener and intern and running point on the show. You're fucking fired. Pack your shit. We actually, Jarvis sent us a funny video that we could use when we fire Ben next time. So hopefully, you know, I can pull that. And anytime Ben is mentioned, can play it like a, you know, a little overlay. Fuck out of here, Ben. All right, BBs. For the BB Bros, I'm Siraj Hashmi.
I'm Jay Kobbe.
We'll see you next time on BB Power. Peace out, Nasalama.